Hey guys, Tech Timmy here. So in this video, I'm going to walk you through the step-by-step process of setting up a TP-Link Casa smart bulb.
Oh boy, it's Tech Timmy time.
And so I've basically already gone ahead and downloaded the TP-Link Casa app. You can see it's the green one here in the corner. There are a bunch of TP-Link apps. If you have a Casa bulb, that is the one that you want. So let's go in there and open that up. And then it's going to ask us if we would like notifications to be turned on. I suppose that's fine. So we'll just say allow. And once you're in the Casa app, they're going to want you to create an account. So let's just go ahead and do that. I'm just going to say enter my email address. And then I'm going to create a password. The bane of my existence, passwords. I don't know about you guys, how you feel about them, but I'm so ready for biometrics. Okay, create account. Here we go. An email has been sent with a link to verify our account. So we're going to have to go into email, I guess, now. So I'm just going to do this behind the scenes, this email piece, and I'll fast forward through this so we can get through this video as quickly as possible. All right, so that's it. TP-Link ID has been activated, blah, blah, blah. So that's good. So now go back to the web management page, or TP-Link app. So we were in the app, not the management page. So I'm going to go back to the app. So we're going to say I'm already verified. And now Casa would like to use your location to determine sunrise and sunset time. So that's totally fine. I'm cool with that. And then we're going to say allow while using the app. And then, oh, looks like it wants us to log in already. What's up with that? Yeah, all right. So now we've logged in again here. And now I'm going to confirm privacy policy, terms of use, blah, blah, blah. Anonymous analytics. I'm fine with sending anonymous analytics and bug reports, sure. Only because it's TP-Link and I trust them. All right, so no devices yet. So now in my living room, I actually have a new bulb that is inserted into my lamp and it is turned on. So we're going to, hopefully it discovers. We're going to say add device. And now local network permission needed. Yep. I've already given local network permission. We're going to say go to settings. And then I'm not sure what that's about. We're going to say we've already given permission. And then I think that's right. And then we'll go here. All right. So install your smart bulb, blah, blah, blah. So it is installed. And now we're going to say next. About 5 seconds. Okay. Let's go. I'm going to go over by the light here. And is it blinking? No, it is not. Okay. So power on the light. And we're going to come back here. It's going to go back to the previous step. First, make sure the power is off on the light you're replacing. Swap the current bulb with your smart bulb. Okay. Power's off. I'm going to say next. Now we're going to say power on the light. Wait for 5 seconds until the smart bulb blinks 3 times. This is not going to blink. No, not a chance. Be shocked if it did. Okay. Smart bulb didn't blink. I switched the bulb through the on position first, then flip the light switch off and on 5 times. Ooh, okay. All right. Can try that. I'm going to go to the wall switch and do that, I guess, for this. Oh, and it worked that time. Okay, all right, very good. So, President Smart Bulb, so it did blink 3 times. So we're going to say next. Now, connect to your smart bulb. Go to your phone settings and join your smart bulb's Wi-Fi network. Okay, so now we have to go from here. We're going to go into our Wi-Fi settings. All right, so here we are in the Wi-Fi settings. I'm going to go to Wi-Fi. And then we should see the TP-Link smart bulb. And there it is right there, second one on the list. We're going to connect up to that initially. And now we're going to go back into the app here. And it's going to say, might take a few minutes to establish the connection. Let's see. Nice. And now, so we're going to choose a network. So in this case, I'm going to choose my 2.4 gigahertz network, which is Tatooine on the top. And from here, I'm going to enter my network password. And then I'm going to say join. And let's see, fingers crossed. Yay, it's doing so. Cycling through the colors on the light right now, very cool. I should have taken a video with my other phone so you guys can see what the light's doing. There we go. So now let's give the device a friendly name. And this one, I am going to call this one, I guess we'll go with the default recommendation, living room. Living room lamp. And we'll say return. And there we go. Now it wants us to choose an icon. So I'm gonna select that guy right there. It's just a picture of a bulb there. I'm going to say save. And now location is, I'm going to say custom. And this is indeed in the living room. And now so I'm going to say done. And that's it. So you've configured your smart bulb and it's ready for use in your device list. So that does sound good. And there's a new firmware update. I'm actually going to go ahead and update that. And there it is. Now I can click on it. And we have shortcuts. You can quickly apply your favorite presets, edit shortcuts, auto white, get started. I'm going to change mine to a lovely lime green color. Actually, let's go with orange to match the other lamp in this room. And so you have schedules, presets, and so forth. And it will also work, my understanding is this will also work with Amazon Alexa. So I'm actually gonna go ahead and set that up. And I think I'll create a separate video for that process. Hope this helped. Hope to see you in the next one. Cheers.